How's it going, everyone? This is Chris from Spoon Graphics, bringing you another video tutorial for Adobe Photoshop. Over on my Spoon Graphics website, I recently shared a free resources kit for creating felt effects within your designs. So I thought I'd use that subject for today's video and show you how to use the tools to create cute craft-inspired artwork. So what we'll be creating is a cute dinosaur character in Adobe Photoshop that makes use of the styles, brushes and patterns from my free felt craft kit. The tools make it easy to apply these textures to your artwork to give it a realistic fuzzy fabric appearance, with little details like stitches to complement the handmade look. Before we start in Photoshop, you need to grab those free design resources. Follow the link in the description or via the on-screen clicky thing to Spoon Graphics and download the pack. Subscribing to my mailing list isn't required when prompted, but it's an easy way to get all my free downloads in one go and to keep up with all my content beyond YouTube. Unzip the package once it is downloaded and begin installing the tools. In this tutorial, I'll be using just the brushes, patterns and styles. There's also an action that adds some extra effects and the original textures for you to create the effects manually. Open up Adobe Photoshop and create a new document. I'm going with a size of 3000 by 2000 pixels. Begin by drawing the outline of your character with the pen tool. Alternatively, you could use basic shapes, text or even paint the shape with the brush tool. Click and drag the points to create a rough outline first. Anywhere you need to create a sharp corner, hold the Alt key and click the last point to remove the Bezier handles. Finish the path back at the starting point, then hold the Command key or Control on Windows to toggle to the Direct Selection tool to tweak the positions of the points. Adjust the curves until you're happy with the overall outline. Create a new layer, then right click and select Make Selection. Add a zero feather radius. Use the shortcut Alt and Backspace to fill the selection with the black foreground color on the new layer, then press Command and D to deselect. Open up the Styles panel, which will be hidden under the Window menu if it's not visible in your work area. Choose one of the presets to have the felt effect applied to your shape. The effect is made up of a bunch of layer styles. You can edit them by double-clicking them in the Layers panel. In my example, the scaling of the pattern overlay was defaulting to 417% for some reason. I think it could possibly be due to my document being 300 ppi. This made the texture look pixelated, so I restored that to 100%. The kit contains two different felt textures, one slightly fluffier than the other. You can choose between them by selecting the appropriate one as the pattern swatch. Under the colour overlay, you can fine-tune the hue if necessary. The bevel and emboss depth determines how much of a stuffed look is applied to the effect. Increasing this will give it more of a three-dimensional rather than a flat appearance. Hold the Command key and click the thumbnail of the layer to load its selection. Head to Select, Modify and Contract, then enter a value of 20 pixels. Activate the Marquee tool from the toolbar, then right-click and select Make Work Path. Enter 1 pixel tolerance so the path closely resembles the selection outline. Switch over to the brush tool and begin setting up one of the stitch brushes. I'm using Stitch Brush Straight from the list. Use the left square bracket key to reduce the size of the brush to match the scaling of the artwork. Then change the foreground color to white. Switch back to the pen tool and right click on the path. Choose Stroke Path from the menu and select Brush from the options. Hit Delete to remove the path to see the stitch outline effect running around the shape. Double-click the layer to add a drop shadow effect to enhance the stitches. Choose a low size with 1 pixel distance and 100% black as the shadow colour, just to add some subtle shading. Add a colour overlay effect and change the colour to a light beige, such as F1EAAD. Create a new layer and select the brush tool again. Change the brush tip back to a basic round brush with 100% hardness. Switch the colour back to black, then alter the size to roughly the right proportion for a series of spines along the dinosaur's back. Give the brush a click to make a circle, then press the right square bracket key once to notch up the size before clicking again. Follow the dinosaur's back, adding a larger spine each time, until you get to the midpoint, then begin decreasing the size again. Click one of the felt styles to apply the effect. I'm using the blue preset. Configure the layer style settings to fine-tune the appearance, then drag the layer below the main body. Command and click the layer to load the selection, then go to Select, Modify and Contract and enter 20 pixels. Grab the marquee tool to right click and choose make work path, then set up a stitch brush again at a small size using a white foreground colour. Select the pen tool to right click the path and choose stroke path to have the stitch's outline applied. Right click the other stitch layer and copy the layer style, then choose paste layer style on this new stitch layer to apply the same shading. Create another new layer and select the brush tool again, this time reduce the spacing to 0 in the brush options. Begin painting a series of little spots on the dinosaur's back. Click the yellow felt style effect to have the texturing applied. Configure the layer style settings if necessary. You can continue layering up details just like you would when cutting and sticking real felt shapes. Draw a circle for the eye and apply the white style. If the felt texture is too prominent, you can always reduce the opacity within the pattern overlay settings. Add a black circle for the pupil and a tiny black oval as a nostril, both with the black felt effect to create a cute dinosaur face. On another new layer, set up the small stitch brush with black. These brushes are configured so they will follow the direction of your pen or mouse. Try it out by painting a little smile. To finish off the artwork, add a new layer at the bottom of the layer stack, just above the background, and fill it with white. Apply one of the felt styles and change the colour to add a pale backdrop. Zoom into your artwork to see your felt textures in all their detail. The styles make it easy to create the effect with just a single click, while the craft look can be enhanced with the little stitch brushes. So I hope you have some fun crafting your own cute characters and scenes out of felt. If you picked up any tips in this video, be sure to give it a like and hit the subscribe button to stick around for more video tutorials. Have a browse around my Spoon Graphics website for loads of other goodies, tutorials and design inspiration. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching and I'll see you in the next one.